All right, guys, we got a big day today. Oh, I had a murder in my neighborhood last night. A husband or boyfriend, I guess the guy, I mean, the guy either lived there or whatever, but the woman knew the murderer. Yeah, domestic violence turned real bad last night. Big day today. First, we're gonna get a haircut. Secondly, it's buy one, get one free sub at Subway today, nationwide, so I'm not sure what's going on there. Haircut, check my P.O. box, and then we're gonna go get my, we're gonna go take the Class B CDL with air brakes examination at the DMV. So we're gonna go do that today. Then when we're done with that, we're gonna go across the river to Hutchinson Island and pick up my packet for the marathon Saturday. Hey guys, haircut complete, and I passed my test. So here's two licenses. What they do, I don't wanna, you know. What they do is you get a paper temporary. So they give you your original license on paper. So that's my regular license with motorcycle permit. And then they give you a printout of your license in paper version of your commercial driver's license permit. So now I have 6 months to take the driving test and have the original, you know, or and have the full commercial license. So step one is done. That's the hard part. That's the knowledge. Step two is the easy part, driving. Big deal. Except now I gotta find a truck. Whatever. We're one step closer to expanding my abilities to survive should something happen, right? So we'll see. But anyways, good news. And now I gotta go by old boy, grab my rent money from him. Okay, so we're getting through my day. Not bad. See the new face behind me? That is PETA. P-I-T-A for pain in the ass. We got her as a teeny little puppy who snuck into my backyard at my old house that I rent out now to old boy. Well, in a divorce, Christina took PETA. But PETA runs. And so it's really hard on them with the kids and traffic in and out of the house. And PETA runs out and disturbs the neighbors. And then PETA got into a fight with the bulldog that they have and tore that bulldog up. Now, PETA and Rocky love each other. And PETA and Manny are fine. No problems. But PETA and Rocky absolutely love each other. They're inseparable. So I gave Christina, my ex-wife, the child support money today. And I'm snatching PETA up for a while. And we'll see how things go. But she's such a beautiful dog. I have no idea what she is, what type of dog she is. But she's a gorgeous dog. So we're going to go home, drop off PETA, grab my paperwork, and we're going to go to the island and go get the my running number thingy. Got to get that done now. All right, guys, it is work day, so let's do some work. We accomplished what we needed to yesterday. Haircut, shaved the side with the razor, picked up my number. It's a little dark. Picked up my number for the marathon for Saturday. Tomorrow, it's now Friday, it's work day. We gotta go to work, we got work to do, but before we go to work, I wanna let you guys know that if you vote for Hillary Clinton, you are a effing idiot, and here is why. Here's a perfect reason why. Do you have DirecTV? Go ahead, turn on Fox News. Turn on Fox News, the cable news, Fox. I think it's on 360 on DirecTV. I used to have DirecTV, I don't have DirecTV anymore. Go ahead, put it on, I'll wait for you. Got a fuzzy screen? Is it fuzzy? Ooh, I just fit. Huh? Can't get it? That's because DirecTV is blocking Fox News so you can stay stupid and only listen to the Clinton News Network, MSNBC, CBS, ABC, all those news stations that are not reporting the latest developments of the FBI moving toward an indictment on Hillary Clinton. So go ahead, stay stupid. I'm just saying, stay stupid. Vote for the criminal. I chose the asshole. Time to go to work. All right, so here's the deal. It's Friday morning. Tomorrow's the marathon. Oh, excuse me, I just burped. And tomorrow morning's the marathon. I gotta be there I got to be parked by 6 a.m. And I got the free parking thing. Now, I went to the International Trade Center yesterday on Hutchinson Island. Excuse me. And I did a separate video of the festivities, of everything that's going on there. So that's going to be as a part of tomorrow's video. Tomorrow night, maybe, or Sunday morning, I'll do a video about my rock and roll marathon experience. And so that's going to be from picking up my number plate to crossing the finish line. And I'm going to run with my camera. So that way we can kind of get everything on the record, you know, from start to finish, what it was like to participate in the Rock and Roll Marathon Savannah, Georgia 2016. And that's what it's going to be titled. So that's separate. That's tomorrow. Today, we're going to the house. Now, I told you guys in the past, in Georgetown, I have a customer. She's one of my favorite customers. And we're going to go to the house where a bunch of freaking trees from the neighbor fell and just destroyed this lady's yard of trees, driveway, everything. And they finally came, I think yesterday, the county came and took it all away. Took everything off her yard, she said. So she texted me and was like, please, can you do my yard Friday or Saturday, today or tomorrow, so we can, you know, get our life back in order and stuff. And she said she'll be willing to pay extra and blah, 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 blah. So I'm just excited to get her yard back, and I'm excited for her. So let's go there right now, and I'll show you guys what's left. I have no idea. I haven't seen pictures. I don't know if there's shit everywhere. I have a feeling it's going to be a complete and utter total disaster. However, behind her fence is open county land of like woods and stuff like that. Boop. Nature back to nature. So that's probably what we're going to end up doing. So let's get there right now and let's see what we got. Holy shit. Holy, holy, holy shit. See that tree? That huge tree was completely across here. Took out the mailbox. Oh my goodness. Wow, look at that tree got snapped. Probably from that tree. From branches and stuff hitting it. Holy shit. Firewood. I'm gonna take that home. Wow. Holy shit. I guess I'll just be here raking. Raking, raking, raking. Let's go check the backyard. Holy shit. This place is a mess. Good Lord. At least she didn't have any structural damage, so that's good. I mean, every inch of this yard is just a disaster. What a freaking mess. It's about 4 hours of work here. Wow, I'm gonna have to call her up. This is definitely gonna cost the minimum by the hour here. Let me call her up and see what I can do. I really need to start remembering to turn this damn camera off. Hit the off button. So this job grew. I'm a little bit winded because I'm raking. This job grew big time. So she wants me to... She approved a higher price, and we also discussed a clean out. So this is a major job today. This is a big job today. So you see all this here? See all this shit? She wants it to look like this. So I've been raking this out. So she wants all the beds raked out and start fresh, back down to dirt. And I already did this here. So we did that. Well, me, and we're gonna rake these, this, that one over there, and that one there. I just sent a text to confirm to leave the plants, just rake out the shit. So we're gonna do that. Here's the deal. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I'm not gonna do this job. This is beneath me. I'm kidding. I can't spend the entire day here, and I can't sit here raking because my back and my hamstrings will be destroyed, and I got the marathon tomorrow, and I got some yards that need to get cut. Oh, look. Hunt Army Airfield. It's a fuel tanker, a fueler, a refueler. One of them refuelers. No, I called old boy. Old boy's gonna come out here and make some money. He's pretty desperate right now, actually. He was like begging me yesterday for work. And I was like, you know, if I get something, I'll give you a call. So we're gonna rake. We're gonna take care of this job today. So he is going to be positioned here all day. And so I'm gonna leave. I'm gonna rake all this out, and then once he gets here, you see more here. Guy's back. What a mess. So I'm gonna get all this raked out for him while I'm waiting, because I want to make sure it's up to my standards. So I'll get all this raked out. So all he has to do when he shows up is drive his truck around with a rake and a garbage can and pick up the entire yard and haul it to the dump. A couple trips to the dump, but I want this yard absolutely primo spotless when he leaves here today. I'll come back and show you guys the final product here. She wants this primo. I want this primo. So she's paying for it, and so she deserves it. So that's what we're gonna do. So I will go back to raking. He should be here in about 15-20 minutes if he doesn't run out of gas on the way. And then I will hand the rake over to him, and I will head on out to yards to go do some yards. So. Okay, so old boy just showed up. His name's James, by the way. Old boy just showed up, got him started. I think I showed you the flower beds already. So I got all the flower beds raked out to the way she wants. So now all he's got to do is stupid work. Just clean it up, spotless, and haul it all away. Oh, and that's what he's going to do. And I'm paying him a pretty good sum of money to do that, for sure. We'll check back on him a little bit later on. I left him my handheld blower. So I'm going to run to my house now and pick up my handheld blower, my other one. And then we'll run up to Pooler and knock out some customers. One of them's a brand new customer that is starting up once a month through winter, and then every 14 days through, you know, the growing season. So that's good. That's a nice new yard. All right, I'm at my new customer's house. So let me show you what we got going on. She had a long guy, but she said he's not. She would pay in advance, but she was paying for two cuts, and then he'd only come like once. So she started getting really upset. So that's pretty easy. Cut a little bed here and there. Yeah, that's a nice one. Nice easy yard. That's some pine bark. That's cool. Cool. Very cool. Check this gate. Yeah, that's a tight gate. I don't know if my 42 can get in there. Cujo! How do I get in here? Alright. There. Cujo! Cujo! Yep, okay. Basic, easy. Easy yard. So we'll get this done. And see what we got.
Hey guys, sorry to interrupt this awesome video, but I just gotta say, if you like what you're watching, hit that thumbs up for me, please. It means a lot. And while you're at it, subscribe. Appreciate you.
right, so we're out of here. Now, you see, that was a brand new account. I priced her over the phone. She said it's been about a month since it was last cut, so I didn't lose any sleep over the condition of the yard. Because, you know, we're in the slowdown season right now. So, I wasn't worried about that. I was concerned about the gate, and as you see, I had to use the push mower to get in the gate. Not that big of a deal, but the question I have for you guys, you have this push mower, and you have a 42-inch. How much time do you think that 42-inch saved me on that yard? I'll wait, go ahead. Right. Not much at all, honest to God. But the 42-inch cost me $3,500 and a trailer. So what if I didn't spend about $2,000 on a trailer and $3,500 on that 42-inch? That would be $5,500 in my pocket. $5,500. Hold on. Stand by. I want to make a point. And hopefully I can follow this point. Hopefully. I don't lose my train of thought. $5,500. $5,500 divided by, this is a very quiet road, there's no cars around. $5,500 divided by $40 yards equals 137.5. So I would have to do 138 $40 yards to break even for just the sticker price of the trailer and the sticker price of the mower. That's not including the gas, the tires, the blades, the oil, the registration of the trailer, the weight towing the trailer, so the usage of my truck, the gas usage of my truck. Just to break even, I gotta do 138 of those yards. Okay, what if you don't have 138 yards, right? What if you only have 20 yards? Should you run out and make that investment? Well, yeah, you should, you could. You should. Because when you have a bigger mower, you can get more work done, you're more efficient. At the end of the day, you're not as exhausted, and you can go after bigger accounts. Okay. Do you have to? That's the question. The answer is absolutely not. There's absolutely no reason for anybody to feel that they have to go out and spend a minimum of $5,500 to get a somewhat good commercial sort of mower and a trailer decent enough that can fit. I mean, $2,000 for this trailer is cheaper than most enclosed trailers because this is a small one. It's only a 5x8. Now, you go and get yourself like a 6x10 enclosed trailer or something, you're looking at $2,600, you know? So I got a small trailer, low profile to fit in my garage because of the HOA and because that's the way I want to live. I don't want shit in front of my house. When I come home after going out or something, I don't want to see my lawn trailer. You know what I mean? I don't want to see lawn equipment. I don't want to see that shit. I shut my garage door, and when I'm outside, I'm bike riding or whatever, I'm me. I'm a daddy, you know? I'm not the lawn guy right now, and I don't want to see it, so I choose to live that way. But my point is, 138 yards have to be mowed just to break even for the sticker cost of this equipment. You don't have to have this equipment in order to make money. That yard, could I still do 138 yards without that mower and this trailer? That is the comparison. Yes, it's not that I can't do 138 yards or like when people are saying, oh, well, I have 100 yards, so that's not, okay. We're talking about the new guy here. We're talking about the guy with 10, 15 yards on the weekend and he's starting to think, what am I gonna do? I gotta do something. What am I gonna do? Great, so this is geared to your new guys, right? That yard is a perfect example of where most yards may be. A 42-inch deck, you're gonna have a lot of yards it doesn't fit into. I'm very fortunate right now. I send a crew out, not during the winter, I'll do it myself, but I send a crew out to do the yards that have gates and stuff like that with the push mower and their pickup truck. I go with my big mower and I do the wide open ones in the yards that have gates I know I can fit into. So I'm in a different situation, but I'm also well established and I have about 100 accounts. I'm in a different situation. Talking about the new guy. You got to do 138 yards to break even on this. How long is it going to take you to do 138 yards to break even on this? Are you in a position to put your business where your income is now going to this? Or are you not? If you're not in that position to where you can give up some stuff, give up income because it's, you know, you got to put it toward maybe even a zero interest monthly payment. You still got to pay it. You know, a credit card or whatever, or maybe you have money in savings. Are you in a position, do you have enough accounts where you can pretty much give up 138 yards this year? Because that's what you're going to do. And you're in this season or in this next upcoming season, you're going to give up the income of 138 yards. That's a lot. That's a lot to give up. And I think you guys should be, I'm trying to navigate traffic here. I think you guys need to be aware what 138 yards is, okay? That's $5,500. So if you can do that, that's great. If you're on the fence and you're not sure, let this yard be an example of your future. You get a 42-inch deck like this. Now, if you have a 36-inch walk behind, it's gonna be a belt drive walk behind unless you buy a used hydro, but you're gonna get a belt drive walk behind and you could fit through that gate. Yes, you can do that, and it's gonna cost you about the same price as this 42-inch zero turn. Belt drives are in a different league. I've had them my whole life and I don't want another one. I want a hydro if I ever get a walk behind again, which I love walk behinds, but they're just too much money. The hydros are just ridiculous. So, all that aside, how much time did I save, how much energy did I save by having this big old mower in my trailer and carrying this trailer? If I just showed up with my pickup truck and my push mower and my weed eater and my blower, I saved maybe 6 or 7 minutes. Maybe 6 or 7 minutes to have this 42-inch mower on this type of yard, on that yard. So, analyze your business. Okay, I'm not telling you get it or don't get it. I'm not telling you do it, don't do it. I just want you to think about it. Analyze your business. Analyze where you're gonna go, where you're gonna advertise. Are your customers, is most of these places you're going to, these new places, I highly recommend you go for newer places that have HOAs because those people will be forced to maintain their property. It helps you with your business. It helps you with pressure washing. It helps you with landscaping, pine straw. It helps you with weed eating and edging and mowing. The customers have to get it done or they get a letter. So I really do recommend you work in HOAs. Might not want to live in an HOA, but I recommend you work in HOAs. Do these HOAs, are these people going to have the little white fences that have the smaller 38 to 40 inch opening? And if so, will a $5,500 investment like this really truly help you? That's where you need to look and analyze and think of your business model before you go and you make a $5,500 purchase and you start chasing $40 yards that are going to have fences. So if you're going to make a $5,500 purchase or more because you want to have the ability to go big, to grow big, then okay. I'm not saying not to. I'm saying then look at your business model and say, well, where am I going to go with my advertising if I do that? Because gosh, I don't want to be stuck having to mow a front yard with my mower and then have to do like I saw Dan do and go get the little mower out, go through the gate. Shit, he might as well have just mowed the whole yard with the little mower. Shit, he might as well have just left his trailer at the house and not towed it for the waste of gas. Exactly. That's where your business model needs to be written down. You need to know what you're going to do and where you're going to advertise and where you want the majority of your work to be. And then you turn around and you go to the next level. I'll be back. Okay, so as I was saying before I was interrupted by my ex-wife, who I still have a really good relationship with, which is really good. You know, it was touch and go for a while there, but now that everything's kind of blown over, we can talk and laugh and joke and stuff about different things, and so that's fine. Whatever. So I just wanted you guys to think about that and think about your business model before you just jump into keeping up with the Joneses. Because I know you guys see all these other lawn companies out there, including myself, doing videos showing you our setup. And we got this mower, and we got this mower, and that mower, and we got 14 weed eaters, and we got $500 weed eater racks, and we got $800 blowers, and you ain't shit. No. At the end of the day, it's about the end of the day, and it's about your bottom line, and it's about investing and having your business model. So know your business model, know where you want to go with your business, know the type of accounts that you're going to be servicing in your area, and as you attack those accounts, you get your machines, you get your equipment, and you know, if you got the money to get the machines and equipment now, great. If not, and you got the credit that you can finance it, great. If not, you're going to work your ass off with a little mower. And I mean, what can I say? It's a rough business. I mean, if you're out there trying to do acreages and you don't have a riding mower or something, you're going to have issues. It's going to be a lot of work. And you can't charge what you would like to charge because people with big mowers are going to get in there, knock them out, $75, $80 a cut, and you're over there for 3 hours, $75, $80, you're like, shit, I'm just not making enough, you know? And then you're dead beat by the end of an acre, you're dead dog tired. So know your model. And structure your equipment to complement the model, the business model. A yard like that, that has little gates, a big old mower. You know what I'm saying? So it's just something to think about. You could always get that bigger mower down the road, down the line. So go back and watch the video series, Two Guys and a Mower. In my playlist, Two Guys and a Mower. Go back and watch that for all you new people that haven't watched that video series. And watch us do 100 yards in 2 weeks with one 21-inch Troy-built push mower. And that'll help you guys out with, you know, going forward with your business, I think. All right. I'll see you guys later. The next video will be my Savannah Rock and Roll Marathon experience from start to finish line. And I will see you guys at the end of it. See ya.